The first question is there, what will be the output of the program? So if you see a Java program is given over here, and if you check out the program properly, you can identify the main part is here, and with that we can have the object creation statements which will directly call our constructor. And one more important part in this program is the static block. This is my static block which is already present, and this is my constructor block. Right now, mostly what happens when the object is created, the constructor gets called automatically, right? So automatic calling to the constructor is done, right? When the automatic calling to the constructor is done, now if you check this code, you can see that A1 is created, so constructor will call, so we'll get C1. Then A2 is created, then constructor is called, you will get again C1. And then you might go to the static block. So you might feel that the output is C1, C1, and S1. But now, the actual case of this particular logic is the static block is having higher priority than the constructor block. So in this particular program, my static block will get executed first and then the constructors, right? So now, if I apply this, my static block will get executed first. So on the output screen, I will get S1. And after that, two times objects are created, so two times constructor will be called, and after that you will get C1 and C1, right? So this will be my correct output, S1, C1, C1. Moving to the next question. Now we have to fill the missing code. Given the following algorithm to convert a binary number into its decimal number. Now to solve this problem, you might be aware about the logic of binary to decimal. Right now, when I say binary to decimal, say for example, if it is 1111, my output should be 15, like this, right? So you have to work on the logic of binary and how it is converted into the decimal. And the note is given that till 10 bits binary number, you have to work on the logic, right? And what is given here? Find num, a function, input will be a binary number, and output will be its equivalent decimal number. Okay. And the given code snippet or algorithm is we have a function, and in that verse, first step is 0 is assigned to the num1, then 1 is assigned to the x, and we are checking the condition of while num is not equals to 0. And there are three statements where the code is missing, and in between we have num1 plus remainder multiplied to the x, and this value is assigned to the num1 variable. End of while loop, and it will write the value whatever is updated one with the num1. What we have to do is exactly we should come in the three code missing spaces above to complete the conversion, and we have to pick out of all these options. Now when we have to replace these code missing statements with the given options, whichever is correct, we have to apply the logic that is giving me the solution from binary to decimal. Now when I say when I want to convert a particular binary number to the decimal number, my first step is to take modulo division, right? So I'm talking about the logic that we have to apply. So my first step will be taking out the modulo division of that respective value with the number. Then second, I will multiply the current value with 2, right? So multiply the value with 2. And the third step will be divide it by 10 so that it will work on the unit places of the digit, because we have to traverse from first position, then second position, then third position, and in this way we have to traverse up to the number of binary digits they have been provided, right? And the trick like 1, 2, 4, and 8, right? And if I have this all ones, then my decimal conversion to this will be 15, right? So if I apply this logic of 1, 2, 4, 8, so I have to take the modulo division, then I have to multiply the value with respect to 2, and then I will divide it by 10 for that unit places so that it will go reduced from this location to this location. Now if I check the option which is satisfying all these three steps, so in the first option you can see the first code missing statement is directly divide by 10, so it will not give me the result. The second option is it is taking the modulo division, but for num1 it is taking, right? And then for the case of num, we have to go with the x divided by 2. It is passing the value, and then the num modulo division by 10. So whatever the variable you have that you have to consider, that num1 is my variable, or instead of num1, I have to write the new updated value, right? Num1 less than, num1 points to the num1 plus remainder value of x. So in this case, modulo division of 10 for that respective number, after that multiplication with 2 for that respective number, and then divide it by 10. So there will be some confusion about this case of num1 and num. So this third option is satisfying all the steps that I am expecting to convert a binary to the decimal number, right? So first I will take mod 10 to the num value, and I will pass that value to the remainder. Then I will use x multiply by 2, and I will pass that value to the x. So I will get a remainder value here at first step. Then in the second step, I am already getting num1. In the third step, I am getting x, where x is multiplied by 2. And in the last case, I am getting num is equals to num by 10. And again, that condition will be checked, where while num is not equals to 0. So the updated value of num will be checked over here again, and multiple times it will work depending upon the number of binary digits you have in the input. And when the condition is false, then in that case, whatever is the updated value of num1, that will be displayed, right? So my option C is the correct option for this particular program. Okay, moving to the next question. What will be the minimum size of stack required? So we have to work on this to evaluate the prefix expression, which is given below. Now in case of prefix expression, we need operand first, and for that I will be reversing the expression so that it will get work. So for reverse expression, I am writing the reverse of this, whatever is given. So like say 6, then 2, 3, multiplication, division, 1, 4, 3, 5, raised to 1, 3, raised to, then again multiplication, then plus, then 2, then we have 21, then plus, minus, plus, minus. So this is the reverse expression. Now I will store one by one into the stack value, and then I will check whatever is available, and up to the case where I can identify the minimum size of the stack, at that position I will get stop, so that it will give me the solution from given options, right? So first I will just put the elements in this order unless and until I got the operand, right? Operator. So operand and operator, this will be the two cases, operand and operator. So we will be working on these two cases. So 6 is the first element now, so it will be pushed. After that we have 2, after that we have 3. So 3 is my topmost element. After that we encounter with multiplication, which is an operator. So when you encounter with such operator, you have to perform that operation on the topmost element and the second topmost element, right? So this will be my operand 1, this will be my operand 2. So I will multiply 3 by 2. So 3 multiply by 2, you will get 6. So after this operation, my stack will be like this, 6 by 6, right? Then I come up with the division operator again. So I will again perform this. So I will get a stack like this, 1. 6 divided by 6. So the element at the stack will be 1. Then I come up with 1, 4, 3, 5. Again the operand. So I will add them, 1, 4, 3, 5. After that again I come up with the raised to case. So 5 raised to 3, right? So I have to perform on these two cases, operand 1, operand 2. So what I get is 125, after that 4, after that 1 and 1, right? 11 is here, okay? I am updating it, 11. The result was stored, and then we got 1435. So 114125 is the current stack position up to this particular expression raised to. After that I come up with 1 and 3, right? So for that case I will be adding 114125, again 1. And in the next iteration, I will come up with 3 also. Now, if I perform, if you see, the number of stack size has been reached up to 6. And if I perform operations after this, there are raised to operation, multiplication, then plus, and again, we have only 2 operands that will be added. So it will get reduced. So from this moment, it will start reducing, right? After performing the expression operation. So I can say that the maximum element, if you solve again above for this particular step, the maximum size element of the stack will be 6 and not more than that. So this is the answer that this question requires the size of stack required to evaluate the prefix expression. Okay, so last option D is my correct answer in this case. Moving towards the next question. Physical layer does not provide, first option is flow control, second is reliability, third one is multiplexing, and fourth one is electrical specification. Now when I talk about the networking and when it comes to the physical layer, which is a part of ISO OSI and the first layer in the model, right? This is my first layer in the model. Now if I talk about the working mechanism of this layer, and if I talk about the services provided by this layer, services provided, and compare these two parameters, working mechanism and services, with other layers, compare it, then you will get the answer of this question, right? Say the physical layer is responsible to handle the bits, because this is the first layer in the model, and whatever the data you have, that is in terms of bits, and which is transferred from one to other in the format of bits. So bits transmission is going to get happen in the physical layer. So definitely bits means your 1 and 0, the electrical signals are there for positive and negative, right? So in that case, I can say electrical specifications are happening in this physical layer. So my fourth option will not be the case, right? Definitely. Now when I talk about the bits transmission as error control mechanism, is not available, right? So definitely if error control mechanism is not there, then reliability of transmission is cannot be attained, right? So I can say with the help of this topic or point that reliability is what physical layer does not provide, right? So this can be the case. Then when it comes to the flow control, as physical layer is only responsible for the bit transmission, the data link layer, the next layer of the model, is responsible for flow control, because it is transferring those data to the network layer. So that flow control is happening in the case of data link layer. So this is not also provided by physical layer. And when it comes to the multiplexing, the transport layer mostly performs the task of multiplexing when it is the services related to the transport layer. So again, we can say that physical layer is not going to provide the multiplexing part also. And the question was what it does not provide. So it does not provide flow control, it does not provide reliability, and it does not provide multiplexing. Only the electrical specifications are provided because of the bit transmission. So if I map these options with the available given, so I can say only 1, 2 and 3 are the cases, flow control, reliability and multiplexing, that physical layer does not provide. So last option is my answer. Okay. Moving towards the next question, insertion sort example is given. So perform insertion sort algorithm to sort the given array in descending order, right? So we have an array and we have to sort it in descending order, and construct BST, that is binary search tree, from the elements of fourth iteration, right? So you can say that up to fourth iteration you have to perform this algorithm, and after that you have to switch to the new concept of BST. What is asked actually, what will be the path between node 12 to node 3, right? So this is expected what they have asked, and the given array is like this: 8, 10, 2, 12, 15 and 3. Now I will apply the insertion sort on this given array, right? So I will write down the iteration numbers, and according to that, iteration number 1, right? So in the first case, I will write down the array as it is: 8, 10, 2, 12, 15 and 3, and simultaneously I will maintain two list, one is like for sorted and one is for unsorted. So you can write down the elements here as well. For better simplification, I will directly write down here, and I will mark the in between line so that it will be differentiated as a sorted and unsorted, right? So in the second iteration, in the third iteration and in the fourth iteration, up to fourth iteration we have to work on it, because after that we have to convert it into the BST. Now in the first iteration, the array whatever is given, and we have to work on the descending part. So we will check for the maximum element, right? So if I compare 8 and 10, so I got 10 as the maximum, so it is switching the position here. So in the second iteration, I will be like having array 10, 8, 2, 12, 15 and 3. Now after second iteration, it will compare these two elements, 2 with 8, right? Simultaneously in the same iteration, it is lower, so you can have the changes like the same, right? so there is no modification in the case because 2 is less than 8. So I will got the same case, right? So this will be my list where I will be sorting again, right? Now I will compare the next element 12 with 2. As it is greater, it will be get simultaneously compared with 8 also, and then it will be get compared with 10 also in the same iteration slot, because it is a maximum one out of these three. So this comparison will be like this, and the fourth iteration value will be 12. Then after that I got 10, then 8, and then 2, and then remaining elements will be 15 and 3. So this is my unsorted, this is my sorted. So after fourth iteration I got the array representation like this. Now what I have to do is, to construct this BST, I have to take the elements from fourth iteration. So these are my elements from fourth iteration. Now when I construct a BST, the rule for BST is like, the elements that we have in the sequential order of array, you have to arrange them in a tree like fashion, but make sure that the maximum element should be on the right hand side, and the minimum element of, according to the weight or the value, should be on the left hand side, right? So 12 will be my root node in that case. Then I am having 10, 10 is less than 12, so it will go on the left hand side of the 12. After that I come up with 8, 8 is also less than 10, so it will go on the left hand side, 8. After that I come up with 2, so again it is less than 8, so it will go on the left hand side of 2. Then I will come up with 15, then 15 is greater than 12, so it will go on the right hand side of 12, and then 3, which is less than 8 but greater than 2, so it will come up on the right hand side of 2. So this will be my BST once I take the fourth iteration element after performing the insertion sort. Now the question is, what will be the path between node 12 to node 3? So from node 12, that is my root node, to 12.3, we have to choose the path, right? So the path will be like 12, then 10, then 8, then 2, and then 3. Now compare this in the available option. We have fourth option which is satisfying this 12, 10, 8, 2, and 3. Okay, so this is my correct answer. Option number 4. Okay. So I hope you got the questions. Thank you.